Hi guys, I have a Copic coloring and card tutorial for you today, and I am coloring Holiday Friends by the Paperness Dolls, and I'm gonna combine her together with the December Simon's Stamp card kit. So I'm gonna use pattern papers, stamp set, and cardstock from that kit because it was adorable and I thought it would fit pretty good with this cutie. So these stamps were released in September, I believe, and you can get them at the Paperness Dolls website. All the links are down below for all of the stamps and materials I'm using today. Also, there is a link to my blog where you can find the close-up photo of the card. So yeah, for coloring today, I am actually using my E50s, and I kind of like the E50s, but not fully, because the E55 is a little bit too light to mix with the E57, so they don't really blend as good as I want them to. But yeah, that's how it is sometimes. Then I'm going to use the darker of the E50s together with the E49 to do her shoes. Also the kind of leather strap on the bells will have that color. I'm also doing the fluffy things on her clothes, and I'm doing that by doing a mixture of dots and kind of very soft U shapes where I want it to be most shadowed. Today I have my light source in the upper left corner, so that the shadows that will be cast are on the lower right side of the character and inside clothes and such. For her hair, I'm again using the same color combination. I'm using the E50s for the whole card when it comes to the browns. I kind of just wanted to have them be coordinating, and I didn't want to use too many colors because I'm gonna give her the traditional red clothes together with the red bow on the very cute little reindeer, and he's gonna have a little red nose also, so just adorable. But the papers I'm using are not red, but I thought they kind of fit it anyway. The winter paper that comes in the Simon's Stamp card kit is all in very light, not really traditional Christmas colors. I really liked it. I really liked the kit, and I kind of wanted to use it with her, so I did. Sometimes you don't have to follow your own rules. Usually I have kind of sort of rules that I try to pick up at least one color from the pattern paper into the image that I'm coloring, because it's easier to kind of match. And usually I also pick up the papers before I color the image, and in this case I actually colored the image before I picked up the papers. So yes. And this is my favorite red combination. You have seen it a couple of times already, and you will continue to see it all through Christmas. And then I am cutting her out. For some reason, I have a tendency to always start at the bottom. I don't know why. It's comfortable. I just realized it right now because I actually did it on the last video I edited. I started cutting on the lower left corner of the image. I don't know, it's a good place to start or finish, I think. I don't know if it's because I'm right-handed or something. Might not be. Might just be coincidence. But yeah. So she got all cut out, and now we're putting the card together. So this is the pattern paper I picked out. One has some stripes and stars, and I thought that would work as sky, and the other has kind of small just lines, which I thought could be really good as Christmas. The card is going to be 5.25 by 3.25. So I'm cutting down my mats to be 1/8 of an inch smaller than that. And I have 2 mats and 1 sentiment from that green, bluish green cardstock. And then I'm cutting down my card base to 5 1/4 by 6 1/2 to be able to score that at a 3 1/4. And then I get my fine little card base. And if your card crackles, that happens sometimes, just rub your scoring tool over the edge and you will get most of the crackle out and no one will see that you have a crackled card base. So that is a tip for you today. And then I'm just putting the cards onto its layers and now I'm gonna do my sentiments. And I'm actually going to do some more stamping because I'm doing kind of a little tree in the background. I'm using my EK Success powder tool because I'm going to heat emboss all of the images. So first I'm starting with this little tree image from the stamp set that came in the kit, which I really like. I really, really like the tree. It's kind of a beautiful. And it's really, really fun to heat emboss these. You're gonna see the sentiment a little bit better later. Sorry that that went outside the frame. And then I found this that kind of worked as a tree trunk. So I just pouring some Hero Arts white embossing powder on top of that and then I heat embossed it. Now I'm gonna cut them all apart and I'm choosing to cut the sentiment with my paper cutter to get a very straight line and then I'm using my scissors to cut out the tree because I felt like I would get a better control if I used the scissors for the tree, even though I'm doing straight lines. I could have used the paper cutter, but I felt more comfortable using my EK Success cutter bee scissors, which are my favorite fussy cutting scissors that I have. Then I'm putting the card together, layering all of these. You're gonna see here in a bit that after I layered the sentiment and the little tree stump, there is some footage away. My memory card got all full. But I am actually putting that tree upon some foam tape. And then I'm putting the same 3M Scotch foam tape on the backside of our little creatures. And I'm finishing it off by putting the layer on top of the card base. And that is the card for today. Thank you so much for watching. If you like it, please thumbs it up. It means a lot to me. If you have any questions, just comment down below and I'll get back to you as possible, soon as possible. And if you want to share this video with your friends and family, I would be really, really, really happy. So thanks again and happy holiday!